What is up, YouTube? Welcome to another video. Hope you guys are enjoying this beautiful Sunday. Although it is beautiful outside, it is extremely, extremely cold. So make sure you guys bundle up and stay warm. I'm very excited about today's video because for the very first time on my channel, I'm actually going to have a special guest. It's actually a good friend of mine that I went to high school with, graduated together, and throughout the years, as we've gotten older, started having our own families. We've always kept in touch. We'd always play flag football together. He's also close with my brother as well. And so I'm actually going to be going to his house later today because he does have a little mini gym in his garage. So we're going to get a workout in. And if I'm not mistaken, we may probably go to the football field and kind of just throw the football around. Just kind of have some fun and, you know, just see how the other day goes. Right now, I'm currently just finishing some meal prep. And after that, we'll head out there. And we'll see you there. Yo, what is up, everybody? We're here at my homeboy Ogden's house. Again, we've been best friends for a while. So we're about to get this workout, in, see what his gym's like. Come on, let's go.
What's going on, Chris?
What's
huh?
Going on,
you good?
Man? What's going on, buddy? Doing all right? Chin. Okay.
Welcome to the dog house, bro.
Ah, shit.
Yeah, I see.
This is where legends are born right here.
Flashbacks.
Hell yeah.
Yo, what is good, everybody? As I mentioned earlier, here at the homeboy's house, see the gym looking good. My boy over here looking good. Bro, what is going on? Look, I'm gonna tell you right now. Does this dude look 36 years old? Hell nah. This dude looks like, what, 25 maybe?
I'm like 34.
I'm gonna tell you, when you have all this right here, like got the back muscle, got all this. Man, when I grow up, I'm inspired to be like him. I'm telling y'all.
He's lying, man. Full of crap, man. Well, welcome into the doghouse, guys. I got my friend here from way back in the days, high school. You know, one of the best football players we ever had.
I was on the bench. Nah, he's just like, trying to do.
He was a great corner.
I was good in track. He's being funny, guys. It's all good.
So he's gonna try to help me out or probably improve myself, maybe little workouts that I might never ran into. So we're gonna go ahead and get in, see we can inspire others. You know, it's never too late to inspire yourself and be able to be healthier. And make it fun out of it. So let's go ahead and get in.
And just to go ahead and let you know, guys. At one point when we were in high school, obviously we were really fit, we were really young. And as we got older, we had families and stuff. We had a little weight that was put on us, but. Like the way you said, you inspire and shit, so able to get our bodies right and to get back to where we used to be somewhat. Look at him now, and then I'm trying to be a living example of that. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna get like a whole up body, what do you say, low body, upper body?
Yeah, do the full body workout. And then after, a little bit of everything, you know.
But then after that, my man is actually a boxer over here, so he kinda tell me how to do this thing, so stay tuned.
We gotta do it. Because think about it, when you do heavyweight, you use your whole body. Let's say you're doing heavy on bench press, right? You bring it down, then you just push it. Here, you can actually control it, because you know, if you don't bring it down level, one side will pull it more than the other. You see what I'm saying? So you just gotta level it out, and then you're gonna feel it. You're gonna see your hands shaking and everything, because you're gonna try to balance it and do it straight.
Gotcha.
All the way.
So I've actually never tried this, guys, so I'm actually excited about it. So I hope you got your notepads and your pens and then take notes, all right?
All right, we got the resistance bands over here. Not putting our weight on it just yet, but just a warm-up. This is what we got for warm-up right here. It's a little something that you could do just to get the blood on.
Everything No, lightweight. Lightweight. Lightweight.
This is chest flies with resistant bands. So this is something that will put extra tension on the upper pecs right here. So we're gonna try to aim for at least 10.
Each side.
On each side. All right, guys, so as I was explaining earlier, so not all people have access to the gyms, and maybe due to injuries that they may have had probably whenever they were younger, or maybe as they got older, not all people could do weights. So as we were doing earlier, showing y'all training with resistance bands and maybe adding a little bit of weight if you're able to do that. But you could also do body weight as well. I'm more of the person that's more into weights because I'm always in the gym. But he does a lot of resistant band training and bodyweight training, henceforth the reason why he has this awesome gym in his garage. So he's actually gonna show me a little cool workout with the board here. And so that way he's gonna do work for shoulders, chest, tries, and back. And so he's gonna give a little demonstration so that we can show it.
So since we're working on chest, pretty much you can do push-out workouts if you don't really have this board. Or if you have dumbbells, you can replace those dumbbells for this
right here.
What I mean by that is, if you don't have the board, you can do diamond push-ups, regular push-ups, wide push-ups. This works the same way. Also, this little thing replaces dumbbells that I was saying. If you guys don't have these, y'all can get some dumbbells and use the dumbbells and do regular push-ups, wide push-ups with the dumbbells. Okay, so in this case, we're gonna use this board. We're gonna try to do, so it's 5 different workouts. If you do 5 of it, it should be a total of 25. If you can do 10, it's even better. That means it's a total of 50. So whatever you guys can do, but always try to push yourselves more. If you're able to do 50, then try to do more next time. The whole goal is to do what you can't really do. Right. That's why you're gonna see actual results.
This is
kind of like that. Right. Why? It's gonna start getting wider and wider. What works for me, you don't have to go too fast. The slower you do it, the better. That means you can control gravity, your own weight, and it works. You burn, you feel the burn more. Another thing, if it gets hard, you can cheat a little bit. Use your knees. Put your knees and then just use your arms to push yourself back up.
Always remember, guys, definitely put yourself. If you, like Heather, what you said, if you work on only doing 10, You know, once when you get that 10, see if we can do two more. And then after that, see if we can do three more. That's a total of 15. Just always want to build it up. Because before you know it, you're building that strength, and you don't even realize it.
So, nice and pretty. There we go. Come on, Chris. How you feeling?
I'm gonna tell you right now, that is actually a good workout. That actually kicked my ass, like no bullshit. That's some good shit. You feeling good, bro? You feeling
good? Yes, sir. Every day.
Every day.
Every day.
Shit. Woo!
Well, you make that shit look easy, man.
When you do it often, it becomes easy, man.
Okay, all right, let's get it. Come on, Mr. 2005 Defensive End Player of the Year. There you go. Yeah. Oh, bro, this shot looks really clean as fuck. Back to them 2005 high school days. Yeah.
I got nightmares in my head, I fear that the thoughts build up until I can't hear. that my mind fills up into a creature, and it haunts me somewhere much deeper. Anxiety, filling up every space, no privacy. And silently, it could build and build until you finally see. Whoa, it's taking over, damn no closure, moving closer. No exposure, I just wanna be a loner. Some can't stay sober, looking over all their shoulders, like moving boulders just to get out of the home. It sucks, I've had enough, I don't wanna feel the stuck under the rug, all my problems that I shove. I got nightmares in my head, I fear that the thoughts build up until I can't hear. That my mind fills up into a creature, and it haunts me somewhere much deeper. I got nightmares in my head, I fear that the thoughts build up until I can't hear. That my mind fills up into a creature, and it haunts me somewhere much deeper. I've been feeling weird, I can't seem to focus good enough. Nothing's really clear, sometimes it could be a little tough. I just need to feel like the end's in sight for me. But let's be really real, anxiety can foggy all this stuff. I've been feeling weird, I can't seem to focus good enough. Nothing's really clear, sometimes it could be a little tough. I just